This is the first Snapdragon 8 Gen 3 smartphone, and I've been running benchmarks on this, playing games continuously, trying to overheat it, and you know what, this has some surprising results. Don't get me wrong, the Snapdragon flagship chipsets in the past few years have been kind of up and down. The Snapdragon 888 had heating issues, 8 Gen 1 had heating and throttling issues, 8 Gen 2 fixed the heating and the throttling, but did not bring major performance gains, so yeah, this has some big shoes to fill. See, we have the Xiaomi 14 Pro with the new Snapdragon 8 Gen 3 processor, and on paper, the 8 Gen 3 looks like a good upgrade from 8 Gen 2. Newer and higher clock Prime X4 core, new and faster A720 cores and A520 efficiency cores. Yes, this is powerful and it shows us the benchmark. There's a massive difference in performance in the Antutu scores of the 8 Gen 3 versus 8 Gen 2. The CPU is faster, but look at the GPU scores. It's a big bump over 8 Gen 2. Now, not just Antutu, even Geekbench CPU scores are a lot better. Just look at the difference in the multi-core score. The Geekbench GPU scores also show you a big performance bump in 8 Gen 3. Now you're probably wondering, how does this compare to the latest all-powerful new iPhone? So here are the Antutu scores of 8 Gen 3 versus Apple's A17 Pro chipset, and the Snapdragon chipset blows away the A17 Pro, be it the CPU scores or the GPU scores. But if you look at Geekbench, there's a different story. The iPhone is still ahead. So 8 Gen 3 does not really beat the A17 Pro, but yeah, it's very close and that's still very good. So from the benchmark scores, it's clear that the Snapdragon 8 Gen 3 is a very powerful chipset, and it's the most powerful chipset I've used on an Android smartphone. Now, I know Dimensity 9300 phones are incoming, and I know the specs of the 9300 are absolutely crazy. I mean, 4 Cortex X4 cores, but yeah, there are also doubts around heating issues with that crazy setup. So yeah, I'll wait till I've tested the MediaTek flagship chipset on a phone. Anyway, that brings me to the big question. I mean, 8 Gen 3 brings a big performance bump, but what about the thermal performance? Look, we have been running benchmarks, we've been testing high-end games on this, and so far, it seems like the phone does heat up a bit, but there's no throttling. See, when running Antutu, almost every flagship phone heats up, some even crash. But we have been running Antutu on this phone multiple times, and there has been no overheat warning, no crashes, and when you check the temperature, it was around 42, 43 degrees, which is definitely not overheating. We also ran the CPU throttling test on the phone, and it's crazy how green and stable the graph is in the 15-minute test, and just look at the super high performance numbers. And we checked the temperature, and it was just 36 degrees, which is very normal. Now, to be honest, the heating on this phone is also a bit dependent on the room temperature, because we did the CPU throttling test multiple times, and there was no major throttling, even in the intensive 1-hour test. But we did get this overheat warning a few times, although it doesn't really impact the performance much. Anyway, not just tests, we played Genshin Impact at the highest graphic setting, 60 FPS, and the gameplay was super smooth. I mean, I've seen a lot of flagship phones stumble with Genshin Impact. So this was impressive, and even after 20 minutes of gameplay, the temperature was only 35 degrees, which is, again, very normal, and the battery drain was also just 6%. We also played COD Mobile at the 120 FPS setting, and the gameplay is just buttery smooth on this phone. I mean, it's kind of expected, and again, when we checked the temperature of the phone after like 20-30 minutes of gameplay, it was very, very usual. See, we've been playing some BGMI on this, we've been playing Asphalt on this, and there are two key takeaways in terms of thermal performance. Number one, there's no throttling or overheating with 8 Gen 3, at least on this phone. Number two, the battery drain is lesser compared to 8 Gen 2. I mean, Qualcomm did mention better GPU efficiency with 8 Gen 3, so that's probably the reason. See, all in all, my experience with the Xiaomi 14 Pro is my first experience with the flagship Snapdragon 8 Gen 3 chipset, and so far it's been really good. I mean, we'll obviously get a more solid idea once we use more phones with the Snapdragon 8 Gen 3 processor, but yeah, right now it feels like Qualcomm saying, hey, we made the most optimized flagship chipset with big performance gain, very good AI capabilities, so just use our chipset instead of making your own and ruining the user experience with throttling and overheating. You know what we're talking about. Anyway, 8 Gen 3 is great, but I'm also excited about the Dimensity 9300. So stay tuned, because we'll be going hands-on with the Dimensity 9300 phone soon. So subscribe if you haven't already. If you don't want to miss that video out, so subscribe, and thanks for watching. See you in the next one.